critics are all around, and they are part of the life of a leader. Have you been criticized lately? If you have, let me tell you, that's actually a good thing, because leaders make the difficult decisions. And if you aren't being criticized, you're probably not leading effectively. I want to talk to you for a few minutes today about how to handle criticism. First of all, don't take it personally. Every good leader faces criticism. And that criticism can come from a wide variety of places, right? It can come from people within your family. It can come from people at work. It can come from people outside of your community. Sometimes you get criticized by your employees. Sometimes it's by your or from your employer. Critics are all around, and they are part of the life of a leader. And so don't take it personally. If you're being criticized, there's a good chance that you are actually doing something right. Second, don't take it personally, but I would encourage you to pray for and support that person that's encouraging or that's criticizing you. You know, when someone starts to criticize you, it's easy to put walls up. It's easy to get defensive. It's easy to start to stand your ground and to build your case. And if you're not careful, you can allow for bitterness to set in your heart and for a bad attitude to develop in your spirit. Instead of having a bad attitude toward that person that's criticizing you, pray for them instead. Look right here. Pray more, worry less, as it says behind me on the wall. Pray more, worry less. You know what I have found is that it's very difficult to be bitter. It's very difficult to hold a grudge against someone that I am genuinely praying for every day. Who's your greatest critic? Have you been praying for them? Do you realize that you're not alone? That leaders that do things and actually lead are going to face criticism. Finally, let me give you this encouraging thought, and that is to take criticism as a learning opportunity. You know, believe it or not, sometimes your critics are right. Sometimes God will use the criticism of another person to make you stronger and to make you better. The next time you're criticized, instead of immediately defending yourself and getting an attitude, why don't you pause and look at what can I learn from this opportunity? Sometimes criticism gives you a great opportunity to pivot and renew and reinvent yourself. Some of the best moves that we have made as an organization and some of the best decisions I have made in my life have come because of criticism. Because it really does force you to pause and reflect and re-pivot. Now question, what do you need to do about the critics in your life? Do you recognize that you're not alone? Maybe you need to just stop having that pity party and recognize that I am in good company with a lot of other leaders. Are you praying for that person that is being critical or for that group of people that are being critical? And are you taking this opportunity to learn and get better? What frog do you need to eat today? Remember, Mark Twain said, if you eat a live frog first thing in the morning, nothing worse can happen to you the rest of the day. For some of you, you just need to eat a frog, and you need to start praying for that person that's being critical. Maybe your frog is to get out of your pity party and realize that I'm not alone, that this criticism means that I must be doing something right. And maybe for you, the frog that you need to swallow and eat is learning and really pausing to look at, hey, how can I use this criticism to get better? Hey, don't let critics ruin your attitude. Don't let critics ruin your day. Instead, let that criticism take you to a whole new level. But it's going to require you to think like the leader that God wants you to be and that you know you can be.